In the name of Allah, God most gracious, most merciful. All praise to God, to Allah, in His glory and His dominion. Dear friends, peace be unto you all. Today is Thursday, 8 October 2015. The Blessed number 153. Continue to say something about the biography of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, what he teaches and what he likes and so on. He's against charlatanism, you know, like juggling. Charlatanism means to deal with the magic. And he is against also egocentrism, which is the disease which reached to epidemic proportion of society, unfortunately, and we have to eliminate it or at least reduce it, because it's in scale which cannot be handled. He is against denominationism, and he's against also he's against Epistrophenus is something, it is not good. And he against diabolism also not good. And also is against the what we call embezzle. Or embezzlement, you know, embezzle, like robbery, stealing the other people's properties. And he's not putting people to do the mummification. Mummification didn't encourage such a thing, because when you die, that's it. Mummification that they did for Pharaoh, bought some chemical substance in a way that the body will not be carnivalistic. And he is against mendicancy to means to be people, and he fight against absolutism also. And brodality, he is against this too. And he is against, in a very highly manner, profligacy. This is too bad. And he never gave anybody exemption. When somebody did something wrong, so no exemption. You got to be the same as the others. He works against the patronage. Patronage, it means to help your people that you know and give them a good job, regardless if he has a good certificate or not. This is not good against Islam too. He came to eliminate feudalism and rascality also. He likes the Muslim to be magnanimous, not to be rascal. And he condemned in very high order the megalomania. Megalomania, it means to feel that you are the best, which is not good. And of course, he is against the pornography, robbery, piracy, parasitism. And I think people know this. And he came to fight prostitution. A prostitute, it means to be a lunatic, or to be, you are not smart. So he encouraged Muslim to avoid to be a prostitute. And also, he is against antagonism. Antagonism, it means make problems with the other. And of course, he's against Bak, listeners. He will preach and teach solidarity, faith, and redemptism, and of course, philanthropy. He came to encourage it and teach it. Philanthropy, it means to love for people, the good thing, and to help them. And he, of course, came to emphasize in a profundity. Being a Muslim should be very wise, very profound person. And he teaches also polygamy. Polygamy, it means to have more than one wife. Whenever you have to do it. And he encouraged educationism. And he's, of course, he came to make people the same and try to help them as much as he can. Egalitarianism, Islam is egalitarian person, the egalitarian system. He also came to encourage exogamous. Exogamous, it means to marry from out of your family. And one of the best to encourage agrarianism. Agrarianism, it means to divide the land, cultivate it, and get it to people in an equal way. And he's, of course, encouraged to be happy, happiness. And he is against abolitionism. Abolitionism, it means to eradicate people, to exterminate people. And he, of course, he encouraged commiseration. Commiseration, to sympathize with people. And to encourage co-religionists, it means to encourage a brotherhood in the faith. He didn't believe in euharism, astrology, fatalism, evaluation, evolution. Hegulatory, phenomenalism, phenomenalism, it is to believe in what you can see, it's the only thing. And fatalism, agnosticism, polytheism, impersonalism, personification. Personification of Allah is not belief in it, or in Allah incarnation. We didn't believe that too. Personify or incarnate. That's not the teaching of Islam. So that's some of what the Holy Prophet believed. And like and dislike, and preach and didn't preach, and against and with. Until we see you next time in the other episode, I encourage you, myself before you, to come and cringe before the Lord. Come and repent. We must repent daily. Reason why? Because we are sinners. Sinners even by the heart. Sometimes we are mock people in our hearts. I feel we do freedom to speak it out to the people or to ourselves, but Allah knows what is hidden in the heart. So we should always try to cleanse ourselves from the bad impression about the others, and try to be smart so no one can stunk you from the holes, any holes. If you have something bad from some direction, don't go back to that direction. Holy Prophet said, the believer will not be stung from one hole twice. And to avoid and to do this, we need some instructions. And that instructions when to work on this, we have clear mind. And clear mind, it means to think right. Our problem in day and time that we don't think right. I meet lots of people and I interact with them and speak with them, but I discover quite accidentally that most of them, they don't know how to think right. And I believe this is sickness in us with a different scale, of course. I'm asking Almighty God to help us to stand against our desires and our sins and our even passions, innovations, because this was drugged us, pull our legs, and make us black sheep sometimes in some situation. And you know, Judas Iscariot is the black sheep of the disciple of the Messiah, Jesus, peace be upon him. And he betrayed him. So every time we have this kind of black sheep betraying us in ourselves, which is living inside us, and we cannot get out of it unless we can't get out of our shadow. So, again, we mentioned this good things about the attribute of the Holy Prophet, to try to imitate him the much we can do, and the least we cannot do, leave it to Allah, because Allah will not punish us if we try the best we can do. Until then, we see you in another blessed by God will. I'm greeting you, saying to you, peace be unto you.